Hey y'all. So it's the beginning of another vlog. Can I tell you how tired I am? I feel like every time it gets to this point of the year, this time of the year, October, November, I mean, we are halfway through October right now. It's the 15th or the 16th. I'm not quite sure what the date is. And really, I'm not bothered to even look. But I feel like every time we get to this point of the year, everything about me just gets tired. My body gets tired. Just everything, y'all. Everything just really, I get over everything very, very quickly. And I feel like that's how I feel about my channel. And I feel like normally with content creation, like people get really, you know, pumped to get content out because December's coming and, you know, a lot of people start doing the, you know, the Vlogtobers in October, and then they do the Vlogmas in December and stuff. I just would never have the time for that. I remember I read a comment where somebody was asking me, please do, what's this, Vlogtober? And I was like, girl, with what time, where? Your girl done gained a little bit of weight too. I don't know where this weight gain is coming from. Actually, I do. I've been eating a lot of those Lay's chips. I didn't gain that much, but it's a good 2 kilograms or a little bit more than that. I don't know where I'm at right now in terms of the weight gain, and I'm trying very, very, very hard not to be too difficult on myself, and it's really not that big of a deal because I yo-yo. Like, I gain it and then I go back to my normal size a couple of days later and whatever. So I'm just really trying not to make too much of it. In the last vlog that you saw, there's a point where I was sitting down and talking. I don't know if I kept this part in the vlog or not, but there was a point where I was sitting down and talking about the latest books that I got. I was talking about Mexican Gothic and The Only Good Indians and all of that. But I mentioned in that piece, in that portion of the vlog, that I was supposed to go out with one of my friends. I ended up not going out with my mate. Where's the thing? I'm going to be doing it now. That's why I'm getting ready. Just pretty much an easy lunch. Really. Nothing hectic, nothing crazy. Just an easy lunch, and then gonna probably come back home and read. I have been reading like crazy. That's the one good thing that's been happening in October. I've already read 3 books. The fourth one would be this one, and I'm including it in October. This is The Girl with the Louding Voice by Abidare. I'm including it in October because I feel like I've read it really in the last days of September, and I really do want to talk about it in my monthly wrap-up. So I'm gonna do that. I don't know what I'll be vlogging because I really just, I don't have that much planned. I'd be lying if I said, oh, I'm going to be doing this, and oh, I'm going to be going here. I'm a homebody, kids. I'm really, really a homebody, and I enjoy being at home. Where's my foundation? I'm going to use my Naked Skin foundation. It's really, really good. It is so incredibly hot in Joburg over the last couple of days. The rains are back as well. Okay, no, it's fine. I won't do that much of a crazy eye look and whatever, so it's fine. The rains are officially back in Joburg, so it's been raining. The last weekend, it was raining like pretty much most of the weekend, so that's fine. It's good, it cools things down, but then a few days later, then it's just boiling hot. It's crazy. I'm wearing the lightest top ever. All right, I need to take this call. Yo.
My lovey.
Ow, lovey still.
The one and only.
listen to you being so cheap. Anyway, so I've just really been working quite a lot. Hence why my content uploading has reduced quite a bit, because I actually have been at work. Don't mind my bra. The top that I'm wearing, I'll actually show you what I'm wearing. I love wearing this top when I'm in the house because it's light and exceptionally just, it's beautiful. It's beautiful, okay? So I've been working quite a bit. That's why the amount of content, I normally put up 2 videos a week. That's gone down quite a bit because, guys, I've been quite busy. But at the same time, I've been quite tired. Pretty much it. My makeup is done. Looking all right. And look at myself in the viewfinder. I'm looking all right. Looking very yellow, very orange. Am I yellow? Am I orange? Or is it the lighting? Goodness knows. Who knows? But I wanted to talk to you about my books, but I don't feel like it anymore. I'm quite indecisive a lot of the time. It's a Gemini trait. We're quite indecisive because the one twin is saying yes, the other twin is saying no. So right now I'm pretty much going to go figure out what I'm going to wear. And then maybe I'll show you the outfit before I leave the house. Let me go and pick an outfit and I'll talk to you guys in a little bit. So I've decided to do a bit of a shoot. I'm connecting my camera to my phone so that I can do the shoot. Getting more so warm, but my camera is connected. So I'm going to do a little shoot now. Say it again, say it again. You're saying you're sorry, so say it again. Only you can make my... Hey! Can y'all see me? It's morning time. And I've just taken a shower. I haven't spoken to anyone today, so you guys are the first people I'm speaking to today, so don't judge me, okay? What I did want to show you, I'm actually not using my camera. I'm using my phone. And here's my camera here. And I'll show you what you see. Hang on. I'll pretty much show you what you see. I've propped you up on the tripod. I'm not quite sure. That's my toilet seat. not quite sure if you can see me as clearly, but I just wanted to connect my phone on here so that I can show you what I normally use for my skincare in the mornings. My skincare regimen has changed quite a bit. So I normally start, I wasn't recording the whole time, but I've already applied this on. I normally start with the jojoba melon seed and baobab facial hydrating oil from Skin Creamery. This oil is amazing. It's so, so good. Oh my God. Whew. I even put it all over my décolletage area because it's so, so good. It doesn't leave any residue. It sinks into the skin very, very quickly. It's vegan. It's a vegan, proudly South African product. So there's no parabens. There's no extra things that you like doubtful of or whatever's in there. In the morning time, I start with the oil and then I come through with the everyday cream, the moisturizer. In the evening, I end with the oil. I'm not quite comfortable with having oil being the last thing on my face in the morning. I don't know. I've also just applied this one on. I'm not going to reapply it. This is the Skin Creamery Coconut Jojoba and Baobab Everyday Cream. This is the moisturizer, also extremely good. And then before I end off with sunscreen, I then follow on with this. This is the Nutriwoman Dermaceutics Eye Lift Gel. Also showed you guys this in my previous vlog, I think. So I take one pump on this side and then one pump on the other side. So I'm looking at the mirror. If you find me looking there, I'm looking at the mirror. And then, yeah, basically two pumps, and then I just rub a little bit and then mostly pat in, as opposed to rubbing, because the area of your skin around your eyes is quite sensitive. I try not to have, in the summertime, I try not to have too much on my face because it's just summer, it's hot, and we're in the middle of a heat wave. So I don't have time. And then I end off with my sunscreen, like literally just four pumps, four tiny pumps on there. And then no one near my eyes, just below, up, forehead, and of course end it off on my décolletage, because I tend to sit outside sometimes and read. But today is far too hot to even sit outside. It's far too hot. That's pretty much it. That's pretty much it. Just done with my skincare. Feeling great. Feeling fresh. Skin's looking kind of fresh. Okay. Did my hair as well. And I'm kind of ready for the day. I started off my morning just in bed reading my latest read, which I will show you as well. And I'll talk you through some of the books that I've read. So, first things first, okay, I've already had two cups of tea, but I've got loose leaf tea that I want to drink now. And we're going to go down and make that. And then possibly maybe decide after that what I'm going to have for breakfast, because I haven't eaten yet. It's going on 12. And so this is what I'm wearing. It's normally like a beach throw kind of thing. With some black tights, because if I wasn't recording, I probably wouldn't be wearing anything under here. But for the sake of recording, you know, I have to just be dressed, okay? But yeah, this is what I'm wearing, some black tights. And this is like a throw that I normally put on over. I've noticed most of my bikinis and swimwear and all of that are either white or this kind of color, like a turquoise, very blue beachy kind of color. So I have quite a few of the throws for the beach, but this is pretty much how I'm dressed today, because wow, it's a mess outside. We're literally in the middle of a heat wave. So this is as comfortable as it's gonna go for me. Can't find myself, I mean, later on I might take these tights off. I am not wearing socks, but later on I might take the tights off. We'll see how it goes. But yeah, that's all I wanted to tell you. Let's go downstairs. Let's make some tea. Let's make some breakfast. But yeah, today is a better day than yesterday, but we'll talk about it. Let's go talk about it. Let's go. So this is my kettle. I got this kettle. It's amazing. I got this kettle from one of my sister's friends, Naledi's friend, TD. She's even a friend to me. Like, I love her so much. She got this for me, I think maybe it was 2 or 3 years ago for my birthday. And she knows how much I love tea, so she got it for me. And it's great because the teapot that has a strainer. This pot is like rubber, and you can take it out. And then it's got a little sieve. See, lid, sieve, and then you put the tea in here, and then you just push down, and so that it can release all the juices of the tea and all of that, blah blah blah. So love that for us today, Sunday morning rituals. And then in here are all my different types of loose leaf teas. Okay, I'd have to get it out one at a time. That's fine. So these are all the different types of tea. We've got forest berries, which it's the second time I'm picking these up from at home. The first time I got them as a gift, and I love them so much that I repurchased them from at home. But this one I really love. Let me show you. This one I really love in the wintertime, forest berries. And then you've got ginger, verbena, which I enjoy quite a bit. It's like just below there. Pink lemon, which I haven't had yet in this batch. It's also quite good. I feel like pink lemon is also nice as a cold tea, if you want to have it cold. So, quite enjoyable. Has a little bit of a ting tang zang to it, a zest to it, and I'm assuming that that's the lemon because you can feel it right at the tip of your tongue. But this one definitely, I feel, would be a fun drink to have on a hot afternoon like today, but cold. So you like add ice to it. I'm thinking I'm gonna finish this one off hot, but because I still have some left, and I'm gonna add a little bit of more hot water to it now so that it continues to steep. And then what I'll do is I will then make it an iced tea later on when I touch base with you guys and we're chilling and relaxing. Right now I'm gonna make some breakfast and eat something. My God, it is so hot. I can't even make peace with how hot it is. And I feel like having come upstairs makes it a lot hotter because downstairs is much more cooler. And yeah, the sun is going in and out of the clouds. So if I look bluish and then 2 minutes I look orange, yellow, it ain't me, it's the sun. But yo, chin, luna, ha! So I showed you a little bit of a clip of the books that I read this month. The only book that I can actually say maybe I read late September, but I'm going to include it in my October wrap-up, is this one. And I spoke about this book briefly, very briefly. I read this book for, what is it? The Brown Skin Reads Book Club, hence why it's got so many tabs, because there were just a lot of parts of the book that I wanted to touch on when we had the book club, and we did. It was actually great. This is a beautiful story, and I think I've discussed this book in terms of the synopsis. I don't want to go into detail too much with regards to this one because I feel like I've spoken about it before. This is The Girl with the Louding Voice by Abi Yare, Nigerian author. Very, very, very great book, this one. And I feel like it's a book that we all should read at some point in time. All of us should read. And then after that, I went into the guest list. And I believe in my previous vlog, I spoke about the guest list as well quite a lot. I was still reading it at the time, so there wasn't much to say. But now that I finished it, it took me about 3 days to read. It wasn't that long, about 370 pages. And insane. I read a lot of thriller books, but this one had so many twists, so many turns. There's always just, in a thriller book, there's always like the one major twist, and then you'll find that there'll be maybe two or three others. This was a twist at every single corner. I was literally grasping at straws, thinking, oh, it could be this, it could be not. The big twist in terms of who the person who died was, I figured that out, and I guessed that, and I was right. And love this book, but the twists and the turns, wow, it was insane. I was kept guessing all the way to the very end. I really, really loved this book. This was a surprise to me. I was looking very, 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 very much forward. I was looking forward to reading this book, and I went into it really excited. Like, it took me a full day to read this book. I started it like on a Saturday afternoon, and then I finished it the following morning. Enjoyable. I don't know about calling it a great, phenomenal, blah, blah, blah. I feel like it was hyped up quite a lot. But for me, it was just an okay book. A lot of the time, it was quite entertaining. I feel for me, it's a light read. Despite the title of the book, which is My Sister the Serial Killer, despite the title of the book, It's very lighthearted. It's very, there's quite a few jokes in the book. Let me take this out, actually. I need to use it for the other one. There's quite a few jokes in the book and things like that. Quite enjoyable. The synopsis is what the title of the book says. My sister is a serial killer. So you have a younger sister by the name of Ayola. And you've got her older sister Korede. I don't know Nigerian names, okay? But they're sisters. So the older sister is a nurse and the younger sister is like a sort of like a fashion designer, a big time socialite, and she is beautiful. She's gorgeous. The younger sister attracts the attention of many men. And basically the dynamic between these two sisters is that the younger sister is known to have men that she dates disappear. Not disappear, die. Basically, her ex-boyfriends die, and her older sister is the one who's called to clean up the mess. So she kills them, and then she calls her older sister like, oh my God, it happened again, da-da-da-da-da. So the book opens with the younger sister, Ayola, having killed her third boyfriend. And the older sister, of course, has to come in and clean it up. Her being a nurse, she's very meticulous. She's just naturally meticulous. She's clean. She loves to clean up. She loves to tidy up. It's a way for her to actually think, and it also is a way for her to clear her mind and all of that. She uses cleaning, which I can identify with, really. So she's quite meticulous with what she does. So the book opens with the younger sister having killed her third boyfriend and then enlisting the services of her older sister to dispose of the body and all of that. The catch comes in where the colleague of the older sister, a doctor, notices Ayola, the younger sister, and falls in love with her. Meanwhile, that time, yeah, the older sister has a crush on her colleague, the doctor, the very same doctor who falls in love with her younger sister. And then that's where things kind of take a turn for the worst. I know I'm not explaining this very well, but maybe by the time I do the wrap up, I will have thought about it a little bit more. I enjoyed the book in the terms of there were underlying themes, which I really loved. Underlying themes like pretty privilege, which if you are a young person who's big on social media and whatever, you will understand what that term means. It addresses terms like pretty privilege and how when you're prettier, things just go easy for you. You know, it's a nice life. It also looks into the relationship of the two sisters, but also how growing up, having issues with your father, having daddy issues, can also directly influence negatively or positively, can't quite say without giving things away, but can directly influence your relationship with men when you get older as a female. So quite interesting, but not fantastic, not great, not, oh my God, it blew me away like it did with so many people. Didn't quite give me that vibe. Currently, today, I started and I'm about, how many pages in now? 38. I'm 38 pages into Jacqueline Woodson's Red at the Bone. Very, very beautiful book, this one, in terms of how it looks. The cover is beautiful. Love the pastel colors. It's stunning. And taking a picture with this book, come on, stunning. It's beautiful. This basically follows the life of Melody and Iris. Iris is her mother. It's very intergenerational, where it follows the life of Melody, but not only Melody, her parents and her grandparents, and even before then, and how the decisions that they made in these different you know, generations, how the decisions that they have made have impacted not only their relationships with each other, with their parents, and also with their children, how that has sort of influenced the way in which they see each other and the way in which they address each other. That's as far as I've picked up so far. I'm about I'm on the third chapter right now, and it's the first and the second are from different view. It's a POV, like a different point of view from different people. So the first one was from the daughter Melody, the second one was from the mother, and then the third one was from the father's perspective. Right now, it is amazing in terms of just the writing quality. Just there's things, I've annotated this one a little bit as well, but there's things about or lines in this book where I just read it and I was like, oh my gosh, that's beautiful. It celebrates blackness, it celebrates you know, the different relationships between different individuals of families, not only celebrates it but also puts a magnifying glass into, you know, a young pregnancy when a young black girl gets pregnant at 16 and has to, you know, make decisions which therein influence her future going forward. It is so far, I need to also collect my thoughts with this one because I can't articulate myself if I feel like I'm still not quite sure of how I feel about a certain book. But right now, so far, the writing, exceptional, exception. One of the sentences I underlined in this that just stood out to me was this one. And it says, look how beautifully black we are. And as we dance, I am not Melody who is 16. I am not my parents' once illegitimate daughter. I am a narrative, someone's almost forgotten story remembered. And I was just like, I don't know if I'll be back later on tonight. I'm really just gonna relax and unwind, probably start collecting, you know, my thoughts in terms of what this week is going to look like. I might have to go into work this week as well. So this is gonna be a very chilled, laid back vlog. Yeah, if I touch base with you guys a little bit later on, I do. If I don't, this vlog might end here, but I'll check you soon.